Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, with this video we are going to start a new chapter in the subject digital image processing. The chapter is called image segmentation. As of now, whatever the chapters we have covered in this subject are actually the fundamental steps in the processing of digital images. So in this list, we have covered the image enhancement as a fundamental step into the spatial domain as well as into the frequency domain. We have also seen the image restoration, then the color image processing we have covered. Then we had the understanding of what exactly the morphological image processing is there, along with the image compression covered. And now we have the another chapter here to start with this video, that is image segmentation. So let us go through the first topic of this chapter. What is image segmentation? So here we can start with our topic, what is image segmentation. So as we are covered with the previous chapter called as the morphological image processing. So before this chapter, actually it was the case in image processing that the images were the input to the processing, and after the processing is done, the output was also in the form of images only. While dealing with the morphological image processing operations, we had a certain modification in that particular case, where the input were of course the digital images, but the output was in the form of certain objective parameters, or simply we can call attributes. So image segmentation, here we are going to start, is another step in this particular domain. So it is a transition from, we can say, image processing methods whose inputs and outputs are images to the image processing methods in which the inputs are images but the outputs are attributes extracted from those images. So segmentation is another major step in this particular direction. To talk about the term segmentation, segmentation actually subdivides an image into its constituent regions or the objects. Now the segmentation based on to the grayscale, we can take an example here. So we can visualize, this is a grayscale image. As we know the classification, binary image that is having only two logic levels, either complete white or black. In the binary terms, we can represent them either digit 1 or 0. Grayscale image is not having a differentiation with respect to the chroma, but with respect to the shades. So this is the example. Another type, we know the color image and the multispectral image. So in the case of grayscale image like this, if we perform image segmentation, so the resultant segmented image will be of this particular case. So in this example, you find different kind of vegetables, fruits in this particular image. So the different objects, in general we say in the language of digital image processing, is denoted here with the help of different color. So with the help of these pseudo colors, in general we can say that the image objects have been represented. So segmented image is available like this. The details definitely we shall cover while having the subsequent lectures of this particular chapter. Next, we can have the segmentation based on to the texture also. So texture is also another characteristic with which we can make the distinguish between different objects into the image. So let us take the example of the image A represented here. So here we have a scenario into the living room. Here we have this particular sofa. This is another sofa. This is the shelf, a small table here, and this is the floor. So these are the images B, C, then D, E, F, and G. So in the image B, we have the representation of the texture of the first sofa onto the left hand side with multicolors here. The second sofa onto the right hand side into the original image is having comparatively uniform texture as compared to the first sofa. So it is represented with only one uniform color. The floor is having uniformity with some another color. The shelf is having many books or some little objects onto the desk also. So they are also represented here with various colors representing the corresponding regions here. So these are the various stages of the segmentation, and now here we can extract the objects into the original image after the segmentation process is covered here. So see here, this is the corner that is having a small desk and the shelf here. Whereas in this particular image, we have extracted the floor into the original image. And the wall is also there having the uniformity into the color. In this particular case, the another sofa is extracted. And the first sofa is also extracted into the last figure shown in the figure G here. Now we have another type of segmentation also where the criteria is somewhat different. The criteria is based on to the motion here. The example image we can take as the input for segmentation process, and making the segmentation here we can obtain the intermediate image. So this particular image definitely with which particular technology is obtained we shall cover in image thresholding, the topic in this particular chapter. And using that particular one, we shall obtain the segmented image like this. So it is based on the motion. Now, another criteria is also there, segmentation based on to the depth. So based on to the depth, this block diagram displays the simple process here. So the original image can be represented like this. And after having the segmentation, intermediate step can be like this. So we obtain a range image. The classification of or the types of images we have already covered into the initial chapters of this subject. So range image is also obtained from the original, here the grayscale image. Then after having a certain algorithm of the image segmentation, we find here segmented image. Now while having the segmentation process done onto the input digital image, the level to which the subdivision is to be carried in such examples actually depends on the problem being solved, the application that we are dealing with. So with respect to this point, we must say that the segmentation should stop when the objects of the interest in an application have been isolated. So this particular process is one of the important steps to carry out the segmentation here. Let us take the example to get this step into the more details here. The example is of the automated inspection of the electronic assemblies. So here in this particular example, our interest lies into analyzing the images of the products being automated inspected here. So here the objective is to determine the presence or absence of the specific anomalies such as the missing components or broken connection parts. So there is no point in carrying the segmentation past the level of the detail required to identify those elements. Segmentation of non-trivial images is one of the most difficult tasks in image processing. So segmentation accuracy actually determines the eventual success or failure of the computerized analysis procedures. Image segmentation algorithms actually are based on one of the two basic properties of the intensity values. So in case of the binary images, the intensity values are the only two. In the grayscale images, if you take for example the 8-bit environment, you can have the gray intensity levels, gray levels right from 0 to 255. So here the two basic properties with respect to the intensity levels we can take, for example, discontinuity and similarity here. So in the first category, that is discontinuity, the approach is actually to partition an image based on the abrupt changes in the intensity level such as ages into the images. The principal approaches in the second category are based on partitioning an image into regions that are similar according to the set of predefined criteria. Thresholding, region growing and region splitting and merging are the examples of the methods in the second category. Now, I suppose what exactly the image segmentation is has been made clear to you people in this particular video. By the next video, we shall be taking the second topic of the chapter. The topic is titled Detection of Isolated Points. So I suppose you are definitely benefiting by the knowledge of digital image processing subject. If you require some more regarding the theoretical concepts, the practical sessions using the MATLAB software or a practice of miscellaneous problems, you can definitely subscribe to eKida channel. Thank you.